Okay, let's continue with our overview of the long list of different convergence tests that we have for infinite series. So let's look at alternating series. Alternating series is a series that is plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. And you notice that in this alternating series, the terms are getting smaller and smaller and smaller. They're flipping sign and they're approaching zero. So I have no idea what this series sums up to, but I do know that it converges. However, be careful. When you have an alternating series, you need to have an needs to shrink and an has to approach zero. Does this approach zero? No, it shrinks. I mean, this thing here is 1/2 plus 1/2n. This gets smaller and smaller and smaller, but it doesn't approach zero. It approaches 1/2. So since the terms are not approaching zero, this diverges. And if you want to give the name to it, it's by the divergence test. But the upshot is whenever you're dealing with alternating series, you need to have things strictly flipping sign, plus, minus, plus, minus. Both of these do that. You know, strictly getting smaller. Both of these do that. And approaching zero. This does it. It converges. This doesn't do it. It diverges. Okay. Now let's look at absolute convergence. Here's another series where I have no idea what this adds up to. But if we call this an, we know that an is less than or equal to 1 over n squared. So the sum of the absolute values of an's is less than or equal to the sum of 1 over n squared, and that converges. Since the sum of the absolute values converges, the original things converges, so that we say this converges absolutely. So by taking absolute values, we can apply all the different tricks that apply to positive series. All of the things in the first lecture were about positive series. You do a comparison to a P series, and you see it converges. Okay. Now, our last two tests were the ratio test and the root test. So in the ratio test, these are both essentially comparisons to exponentials. So here we're going to apply the ratio test to this one, and we say an plus 1 over an is, let's see, that's n plus 1 squared times 2/3 to the n plus 1 divided by n squared times 2/3 to the n. And that's 2/3 of n plus 1 over n squared. And that approaches 2/3, which is less than 1. The ratio, the limit of the ratios is less than 1. So this converges. The factors of n squared really come along for a ride. And when you're applying the ratio test, you really want to look for things like powers of a number. If you have 2/3 to the n, when you take the ratio test, you're going to get a 2/3 out of it. Powers of n don't really affect things because n plus 1 over n gets closer and closer and closer to 1. So if you look at this series here, you've got an exponential piece and a power of n. And when you do the ratio, it's going to be 3/2 to the n plus 1, and you're going to get a 3/2 to the n, and then divided by n plus 1 to the 5th divided by n to the 5th. So you get the 3/2 times n over n plus 1 to the 5th. N over n plus 1 goes to 1, just like n plus 1 over n went to 1. That doesn't affect the ratio. The ratio goes to 3/2. This is bigger than 1, so this series diverges. Actually, you could have gotten that it diverges by the divergence test. The terms eventually get bigger and bigger and bigger. That's what happens whenever you have a ratio test with a ratio bigger than 1. It's not that just that it fails to converge, it's that the terms are getting bigger and bigger and bigger. There's no hope of it ever converging. Lastly, we have the root test. The root test is good when you've got an nth power explicitly in the exponent. That makes it easy to take the nth root. So if you call this a n, then the nth root of that is 1 minus 1 over n squared to the n squared. Now you should remember that one plus a constant over n to the nth power goes to e to the n. So e to the r. Well, the same thing works if you have an n squared in there. This approaches e to the minus 1, which is less than 1, so it converges. In general, you want to use the root test whenever you've got something where you can take the nth root without much trouble. Things that have an n in the exponent, you can take an nth root without much trouble. Applying the ratio test to this would be a mess. On the other hand, applying the root test to this would be something of a mess because you'd have to figure out how do you take the nth root of n to the fifth? How do you take the nth root of n squared? The root test, it can be done, but it's hard. There's some problems where the ratio test is easier to apply. There's some problems where the root test is easier to apply. Neither one gives you more information than the other. They both really are comparisons to geometric series. Given a choice, use whichever one looks easier.